In 1995, Dr. Stancic's medical career was about to take off. She had just accepted the job of chief resident for the next year. And while she was focusing on infectious disease, she was considering a gastrointestinal fellowship for after graduation. She was a 28-year-old, young, energetic, third-year medical resident on call at Beth Israel Medical Center, midway through a 24-hour shift at the hospital. At around 2 a.m, she got into bed, but within the hour she was awakened by a call from the emergency room. As she tried to jump out of the bed, she found that she'd lost feeling in her lower extremities and was unable to feel anything below her belly button. Something was very wrong. She then herself was emergently rushed off for an MRI. The result of this scan was to change her life. It revealed multiple plaques in her brain and spinal cord, and she was given the diagnosis of multiple sclerosis. After that came drug after drug, all with their many side effects. She says, MS had swiftly swept away my dreams and aspirations and left behind a shadow of my former self. Dr. Stancic eventually reached a point when the side effects of medications, chills, fevers, pains, injection site reactions, and overwhelming fatigue, became unbearable. An alarming reaction to a steroid injection once caused months of vomiting and weight loss from undiagnosed steroid-induced hepatitis, which required 2 liver biopsies and weeks of hospitalization. However, 2003, after nearly a decade of a life compromised by chronic illness, her life was about to change once again. Dr. Stancic came across an article in a medical journal touting the benefits of blueberries in MS patients, and how MS patients who ate blueberries had improved symptoms compared with those who did not. The investigators attributed these results to the berry's antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties. She says, "The scientist in me was skeptical, but this publication had the effect of igniting my curiosity. Could food play a role in ameliorating or even preventing chronic illness? I was consumed by this idea and driven to explore existing medical literature in search of answers." She found that there was a huge amount of evidence in respected peer-reviewed medical journals that diet does play a key role in the development of chronic illness. Her research led her to the unquestionable results of a whole food plant-based diet. Dr. Stancic decided to discontinue all her medications and focus solely on her diet. As the months and years passed, she began to see small improvements, like less dependence on her cane, or feeling invigorated enough to stay awake past the evening news. She said, "I even had the audacity to envision a future without a wheelchair." Years passed and I continued to mount gains. I planted another irrational seed. I would someday run a marathon. It seemed borderline heresy when first introduced as a viable possibility, because MS patients don't run marathons. Then, in 2010, just 7 years after changing her diet, Dr. Stancic crossed the finish line at the New Jersey Marathon. In 2012, she left her position as Chief of Infectious Diseases and decided to start a lifestyle medicine practice in hopes of empowering and educating others to take control of their personal health. She lectured in schools and churches, wrote articles, gave interviews promoting this powerful message, but she felt like this wasn't enough. She says, "I knew that in order for this to become a sweeping movement, I would need to engage and convince my professional community, that is, other doctors." So Dr. Stancic then decided to produce a documentary called Code Blue, Redefining the Practice of Medicine. It's a feature-length documentary that reveals insufficiencies in the current state of medicine and provides a common-sense solution by featuring the practice of lifestyle medicine to prevent, treat, and manage disease. It presents the hurdles to the proposed shift. Why is this not an integral component of the curriculum taught in medical schools? For more information about her film Code Blue, go to www.codebluedoc.com. To help share Dr. Stancic's vision, you can also donate via the link in the description. Today, Dr. Stancic is living a full and active life. Doctors predicted she would be in a wheelchair by now. She's still educating patients on the power of a whole food plant-based diet at her innovative medical practice, the Stancic Health and Wellness in Ridgewood, New Jersey, and has authored several research papers in peer-reviewed journals. Here's what she eats in a typical day. For breakfast, she has oatmeal with added ground flaxseed, cinnamon, and a few walnuts, always accompanied by a bowl of mixed berries. Lunch is always a big colourful salad chock full of legumes and veggies. And dinner is either a plant-based chana masala, black bean burgers, mushroom and zucchini pasta, or veggie four bean chilli. She always starts every dinner with a big green salad. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe for more upcoming videos.